Right, again, I'd like to thank everybody for coming, and the Ward Brothers have got a pretty special announcement to make in the fact that Jeff has re-signed as the player coach for next season. We are obviously delighted with that news, and I'm sure that everybody else will get behind us and wishing Jeff all the best for the coming season. He's going to say a few words at the end of the presentations, so at the moment we'll keep that on one on hold until the end of the presentations. I'm sure you'll all agree it's been quite a season for the Stars. We've had a lot of great nights in Dundee, a lot of winning performances, and a lot of that's been borne out today with two players being announced in the Sports Writers All-Star team, one being the goalie Nick Riopelle. Big hand for that. That's easy. And the other player being Sammy Ryanen, who's just been picked for the top point scorer in the league. So well done, Sammy. But I'm sure on behalf of everyone at the club, including everyone who works for the club, we'd like to thank all the players for this season, because it's been a really entertaining year. With this fall a bit short at the very end, which everybody's been a bit disappointed about, but I'm sure everybody's had a good time watching the team play. So can we give them all a round of applause? The English have done great this year.
Thanks very much. The Travel Club would like to thank everybody who supported them, not just travelled on the bus, but also bought raffle tickets, etc. We've got three awards tonight. The main one is Player of the Year, but we felt that throughout the season, the votes have been very close. And we wanted to give a prize to not the top three, but two people in particular who are always up there. So the first prize we'd like to ask Greg Muir to come down and you see the stuff. The next one is someone who we decided to sponsor because he put his body in the puck. The first three games he was always injured, he always came back on the ice, and we thought he was fantastic, and the Travel Club thought he was fantastic. He was always thereabouts as a voting, so I'd like to ask Pat Bowen to come down as well, please. To say is he had 2,170 shots on him.
Well done, Miguel.
And he saved 1,986. We thought that this guy every week done 100%. He was a credit to the team, and by the way, it wasn't just him, it was the guys in front of him that made him sometimes look good, but he was fantastic. I'd like to ask Nick Riopelle to come down. Thank you very much.
Martin Dean, but they're doing an absolutely fantastic job again for the club. They've got the supporters going to away games we never went before, so listen guys, these guys deserve a big round of applause. Well done guys, thanks very much for all of that. And please keep it going, because it's really important you guys have got support away from here. Thanks very much.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank all the programme contributors actually for the wonderful job they've done all season, and as they do every season. Very much, guys. There's about 120 votes, or 120 points, been up for grabs this year through our 8 contributors.
Just think it's a 99.
And at the end of the day, it was pretty clear cut. Lots of votes for people like Doug Krantz, Sammy Ryan. Who else? Billy Bargon.
Billy Bargon.
The clean winner, overwhelming, Nick Reappel.
This guy came to us this year after playing last year in Hull. One good thing about going to Hull last year was that he played a hell of a lot, and he came back to us a better player. And I thought over the course of the year, he even got better and better. Sam McCluskey.
I guess it's not me. there's really not much more you can say than what he's already said about him. Nick, get down here.
This next prize is it was a guy, Tom Wilson, who everybody I'm sure knew of at the club. He passed away sadly a couple of years ago, and we do a prize now every year, the Tom Wilson Memorial Trophy. It's not necessarily for a player, it was the first year, but this club depends on 40 to 50 people turning up every week, doing whatever they do for the club. They do absolutely everything behind the scenes. Without them, this club wouldn't exist. They're important as the players at times. Obviously, they don't go on the ice, but they do everything to make this club run on match nights and during the weekend at all times. And it's very important that I think these people are recognised from time to time. And that's how we like want to do this prize. This year, the guy who's actually standing at the video zone have to come forward because it's Graham Easton. Okay, Graham, thanks very much. And I should add, we've given Wayne as well as Graham the prize, because without Wayne as well, these guys do all the Stats TV, video all the games, writes the programme, hangs me and my brothers for stuff for the programme, wants to get involved in the school visits. This guy did absolutely everything. If he was young enough, he'd probably try to play. So a big round of applause for us, and that's fantastic. Okay, cheers. And Wayne as well. Unfortunately, Wayne can't be here. He's in Hollywood filming his next movie, so.
Yeah, I appreciate it very much. Thanks to the Ward brothers, thanks to everybody. Tom Wilson, I don't know if everybody knows Tom or knew Tom, the great guy he was, and it's a real honour to have these presenters tonight. Thanks very much.
Margaret's going to announce it. Here, sir.
Oh, Margaret. And this one is a surprise. It's Nick Reappel.
Rio.
Well, thank you very much. I think we had a great year all around. I just wanted to say thanks to my teammates. Without them, I would receive maybe 50 to 60 shots a game. So, but thanks once again. I want to mention a guy that gave me the opportunity for me and my family to live a great experience. I'm talking about Jeff Hutchins. To come here and live a great experience with a great bunch of guys and a great group of fans. So once again, thank you very much for everything.
Welcome back. Thank you.
All right, guys. The last award is for the Coach's Player of the Year. It's not real. Can't give him everything. This guy, you know, he was the last signing, one of the last signings I made over the summer. You know, he's an older guy. He's a true veteran, and he's done a lot on and off the ice for us. You know, he's done charity work. You know, we call him Mr. Glass. He broke his thumb early on in the season, and you know, he's been a leader for us all year. He's come back. You know, the guy's broke his toe, took injections to play games, and I just, you know, think his leadership kind of resonated throughout the team, and that's why he's my Coach's Player of the Year, Doug Krenz.
I actually told him no the first time when I was coming over here. I said I can't do it. You know, I got a girl back home who's important to me, and I gotta start moving on with my life. And he came back and said, you know what? I really want you over here. I've heard good things. I want to put a good team together. And you know, I have absolutely zero regrets for coming over here. The fans have been amazing. Teammates, can't say enough about you guys. I had a great year. Obviously, it didn't finish the way that we wanted to, but you know, I got a lot of great memories. Unbelievable year. I don't know what else to say. Thanks to the fans. I got so many people to thank. I'm going to forget people if I start saying, but, you know, Derek for doing the photos, doing the video, setting up the golf. That was great for us. Helping me out with Movember. That was phenomenal. The Wardies for bringing us over here, helping out my family and my fiance when we came to visit. And thank you to all the fans, Travel Club, for showing up at every game. Unbelievable. That's enough. I'm done. Thank you.
Well, I'll start off by thanking you guys for coming tonight. Again, I echo all the guys that came up and said, you know, it didn't finish the way we wanted. You know, I said to the guys the last game of the season that, you know, it's probably the best team that we've had here in 3 years, and it's just disappointing that, you know, we didn't take that extra step. And, you know, the league was so tight this year, and you know, our conference was really tight. And, you know, for us to be playing for a conference championship in the last weekend of the season, you know, is a good accomplishment in itself. You know, if you look at the positives and, you know, our 6-point away weekend, I think, was probably one of the highlights for, you know, us as players and hopefully for you guys as fans. You know, first of all, I want to say thank you to the guys in the Travel Club, Graham, Derek, you know, and all the fans. And if I missed anyone, I apologize. But as far as next year goes, I'm very excited to be coming back. you know, I feel like I have something still to accomplish, you know, and I think, you know, there's a big empty hole in my stomach at the moment, and, you know, I apologize to everyone, and I feel like we've, you know, we could have done better, but sometimes these things don't work out that way. You know, to all the guys that I brought over, I thank you all for your commitment. You know, I've told you this before, but, you know, it was a tough year for me personally to adjust, you know, to coaching and playing. And, you know, I think, you know, I've learned a lot of things, and hopefully I take those forward next year into the new season. And again, hopefully I have your continued support throughout the organization. Thank you very much. Enjoy your night.
It's Lindsay's birthday today, so we'd ask AJ to present with a card for the stars, okay? Happy birthday, Lindsay. Thanks very much to everybody. That concludes all the presentations. Sandy will be ready to strum up pretty shortly, so if you just sit back, relax, enjoy the night, and we'll talk to you all soon. Cheers.